Four dismantling joints are flanged joint fittings that provide longitudinal adjustment in a flanged piping system. FFCA style A with ductile iron body and end ring, or FCA style B with carbon steel body and adjusting pipe, are each assembled following the same steps, either using tie rods or without. Before any installation, refer to the instructions packaged with your Ford product. Remove any plastic ties from the assembly and inspect all FDJ parts to ensure no damage has occurred. Verify the mating flanges to ensure they match the FDJ drilling. Verify the space requirements for the dismantling joint to function properly. When installing an FFCA-style iron FDJ, remove the nuts from the cross bolts on the O-ring end of the assembly. On the coupling end, retract the nuts to the full extent of the cross bolts. For an FCA-style steel FDJ, loosen the end ring bolts to allow the FDJ to expand and contract freely. Position the contracted FDJ between the mating flanges and properly block and shim all components for proper safety and alignment. The spool piece must remain inserted a minimum of 2 inches into the flange coupling body at final assembly.
We've double-checked our bolt pattern. It matches up with that. Our lay length is good as far as minimum and maximum with the assembly that we have. The flange gaskets just simply snap onto the face and stay in place, where if you have a dropping gasket, you're going to want to make sure that you have your bolts ready to slip in so that your gasket doesn't fall out. We're going to go ahead and slide this into the opening.
Connect the flange coupling body to the mating flange. Insert cross bolts into the flanged end of the mating pipeline and loosely install nuts. If using tie rods for restraint, leave spaces for them evenly around the circumference. Evenly and alternately tighten all fasteners at the O-ring end to secure the flange. Identify torque values from the chart provided.
When you're installing these, you're going to want to make sure that you get all your fasteners in first to make sure that they all fit effectively. Once you get those in, you're going to want to tighten these fasteners down to where they're finger tight on this first side. Once you get all of these in, you're going to move to the slip pipe side, and you're going to slip. Then you will slide that over and put your all of the fasteners in, all at finger tight.
For an FCA-style steel FDJR, insert the tie rods into the holes remaining open. Thread 2 nuts on each rod between the mating flange and the back of the slip pipe flange, and then insert the rods through the slip pipe flange. The rods do not go through the coupling end ring and must pass entirely through the mating flanges on each end. When installing an FFCA-style iron FDJR, expand the FDJ and mate the slip pipe flange to the opposite flange with a proper gasket between them, leaving the slip pipe a minimum of 2 inches into the body at final assembly.
When you go to install this, you're going to want to make sure that you loosen up your fasteners here at your compression ring, so that you can take your slip pipe so you can slide it over, but you're going to want to make sure that the gasket is lubricated prior to installation so you can get an effective seal generation on that. So once you get this up into place, these are tightened down finger tight, you go ahead and slide this flange over, line up your holes, and then start applying your fasteners. Depending on how much space you have, you may have to, the nuts may have to go towards your compression ring depending on how much space you have.
Install flange bolts and tighten according to the manufacturer's specifications. Insert the tie rods into the O-ring end flange holes remaining open. Thread two nuts between the coupling end ring and the back of the slip pipe flange prior to inserting the rods through the slip pipe flange. The rods must extend through the coupling end ring and beyond the mating flanges on each end.
Okay, I've got two rounds of torque on that side. I'm going to come back to this side here and get my second round of torque on this one. We have two rounds of torque applied to this. The third round of torque will be applied after the line has been pressurized, just to ensure that no excessive relaxation has occurred after pressurization.
Finger tighten all coupling end ring bolts. Snug the two tie rod nuts against the inside of the slip pipe flange. Tighten the two inside tie rod nuts that secure the flange to the same torque as the cross bolts on the O-ring end. Hold one and tighten the other. Then, evenly tighten the end ring bolts in an alternating pattern. Be certain the end ring stays parallel to the flange and perpendicular to the center line of the pipe. Use a torque wrench to ensure the proper torque has been applied. Recheck the torque on all bolts after pressurization of the line.
The torque being applied to this compression ring is going to be the same torque that is applied to your end seal, which is 75 to 80 foot-pounds of torque. Once again, you want to do that in an even and concentric fashion. Once you get torque achieved the first time, then in a symmetrical fashion, then you can just chase the torque all the way around. So that is a dismantling joint installed. Once again, once the line is pressurized, you want to go back and double check that all of your seals still have maintained their torque. Some relaxation may occur with pressurization, so you always want to go back and double check it before you're finished.
Four dismantling joints provide flexibility during design and installation, as well as easy access for maintenance down the road.